Get ready to match the stars. George Kennedy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Loretta Switz, Richard Dawson, and Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reilly!
We must stop meeting like this. Thank you for joining us. You're going to have a good time because the lunatics are loose.
Can I just show you what he's doing now?
What is
she
doing?
Don't show the brand. We'll get in trouble. Show how a sick woman pours club soda with the cap on. Just look at that so they let the nation see what I'm living with.
First he tried to open it, then he tried to open it.
They're not strong like
that. Now let's watch. There should be music under this strongman music.
Okay, Bree and Larry, are you ready?
Yeah.
She's done very well. How much money have you won? $700, right?
Right.
$700. You didn't even remember that you won $700?
I knew I won some money.
You did?
That's enough.
Now, she won two games, and she's going to do the second half of the Big Money Super Match in a moment or so, and we wish her the best of luck in that, and we'll do that right after we do this. Hello there. Nice to have you with us again. Here's Bree and Leary. He's won our second game, and we're going to have a go at the big money now. Ready? We polled a recent studio audience, Bree, and we got their best response to this. Blank pads, P-A-D-S.
Oh.
Remember the answer they gave most often is worth $500 every match, a $250 for the second most popular response, then $100 if you hook up with their third most popular answer. Let's see what help we'll get from our celebrities here.
Betty?
Launch pads.
Launch pads, okay.
Brett.
Knee pads.
Knee pads.
But I wear constantly when I'm scrubbing floors.
Sure you do.
And George?
Elbow. Elbow pads.
Elbow pads. So you got elbow pads, knee pads, and launch pads. Now you can reject all three of those and give us a peachy answer of your own if you want to. Or you can choose one of those. What would you like to do? It's up to you. Anything you say. What?
Oh, knee pads.
Knee pads.
I know, but I...
What do you think is a better answer? What?
What?
Corn pads.
What?
Corn
what?
Pads.
Corn pads?
Note pads. No. Yeah, scratch pads.
Deodorant.
All right, Brian, you've chosen knee pads. Let's see if it's up there, and if so, where? May we see the $100 number? Lily pad. Was that kind of bunch, eh? Well, the flower lovers were in that day. May we see the $250 number? Yep. Knee pads it is. Congratulations, you. You got another $250. Now you're up to $950. And it'll be kind of weird if the audience is right, isn't it? Shoulder pads. Oh, hot pads. Boy, there are a lot of good ones here. Okay, Earl, slide it. Shoulder. They were right. By Jove, they were right. I never even thought of that one, did you? Okay. Smart audience out here today. They had it right from the...
We'll sit down there.
Oh, yeah. You want to come up here? We'll sit down there. You do the show there. Okay. Now, you got $250. You play for 10 times that amount or $2,500, and you have to choose one celebrity now and make an attempt to match that individual exactly.
Betty, please.
Okay, Betty.
Here
we go.
The record has not been the greatest.
That's all right, kid. I got faith in you.
Oh,
what?
Bless your heart, Brian.
You got faith in her?
I got faith
Let's
in her.
Get it together, girls.
All right. Stand on the adhesive tape there, on the shoulder pads that we got on the floor there. Here it is, worth $2,500, and it goes as follows. Venus blank. V-E-N-U-S blank. Venus blank. All right, Brian, Betty's made up her mind. We ask you to give us a response which you think will match hers. Get your ESP flowing to her and tell us what she wrote on the card. Venus...
De Milo?
Venus de Milo. You say it with a question mark in your
voice.
Because
I'm not sure if that's how you pronounce it.
Venus de Milo is correct. Well done. She says Venus de Milo will match you for $2,500. What do you say to that?
Well, I'm so hung up in the space thing with the launch pad.
Oh, Venus.
The planet Venus and everything. Yeah. I'm sorry, I said Venus de Milo.
Talk about your piercing scream. That was a piercing scream.
You got $3,450, and we congratulate you, and we're very happy for you. And, Brian, you're going to meet another player right now, and if you've got it together, we'll bring on Kay Henry. Kay Henry. Hello there. All right. Kay, you know Brian. Now, Kay, we welcome you and ask you to tell us the Kay Henry story.
Okay, I'm a homemaker, and I have three beautiful children, Kristen, Jason, and a brand-new little bicentennial baby, Ryan Patrick.
Okay. Congratulations on all of those activities. And the best of luck to you here. Now, Kay, we'll ask you in a moment or so to make a selection, but right now we got to do a little business with America. We'll come right back to you. Hurry back. Here we go. Now, you may have a choice of A or B, Kay Henry.
I'll take A.
You want A? Now, we got a new game going here.
Okay,
everybody will play.
Wow, man.
King Arthur said.
I love King Arthur.
He said, he talked a little funny. He said,
yes.
He said, I don't like that Arabian sheik. King Arthur said that.
Yes.
He said, I don't like that Arabian sheik. He moved into the castle next door and turned it into a used blank lot. I don't like that Arabian sheik, or sheik, as they used to say in those days.
Sheik.
Terrific. You got it.
Do you know, I thought you said Jean Arthur?
No, King Arthur. Moved into the castle next door.
No, I understand it. Now that I know it's what it is, I understand.
You got it.
Good, it's adorable.
Isn't it adorable? What are you doing down there, you dirty lady? Get out of there.
No, I was trying to tie your shoe.
My head.
Oh, you sweet. Thank you very much.
Okay.
She's untied. All right, ready. Here we go.
Okay.
All right, Kay Henry. King Arthur said, I don't like that Arabian sheik. He moved into the castle next door and turned it into a used blank lot.
Camel.
Camelot. She said... He turned it into a used Camelot.
Camelot.
Camelot. Yeah. Sing a little song, George. Camelot.
This may come as a shock to the world. Camelot.
Oh. You are improving. Your cold is getting better.
Yes.
What do you say, Charles?
Lot de Camel.
Camelot. Kay Henry, you've matched three of the celebrities in the upper tier, all of them, in fact. Now we come to Loretta Swift.
Whose head is somewhere else. I thought it was a harem lot.
A harem lot. Turn into a used harem lot.
More fun.
Interesting idea. What do you say to that?
Best friends,
I say Camelot.
Camelot there. What do you say to this?
The rain may never fall till after sundown.
Yes, there's a song. Betty, well done. That's five for you. Brian, let's see how you do with yours. Hey, did you see the new book at the bookstore? Let me tell you about it. It's the thinnest book ever written. It's called The Collected Wisdom of Blank. The Collected Wisdom.
What is it? Let me say.
It's the thinnest book ever written.
Thinnest book?
Yes. It just came out.
Fuck that up, Will.
Okay, they're just about ready. I'll stroll over here to Bree and Larry. Bree and Brannigan and Larry.
Bannigan.
Bannigan. B-A-N-N-I-G-A-N. Oh, they're finished. No, not finished. You finished, Brett?
Yes, Dad.
Okay. The new book at the bookstore. It's the thinnest book ever written. It's called The Collected Wisdom of...
Brett?
Brett?
I know.
A rather hostile thought directed at you. What do you say to that?
No.
No. Not no. Brett, right?
No.
No.
Howard Costell.
Howard Costell. A good one. The Collected Wisdom of...
I'm going to get you. Betty White, Alan Ludden's wife.
Yeah. They're married, you know. Hello, Charles.
The collected wisdom of Brett. You see, let me explain.
Tell me.
Like, adorable things like when she tries to pour the club soda through the cap still on the bottle is called a Brettism. They're
a
adorable. Brettism.
Yes, they are adorable.
She's a sick woman.
But you're okay, Charles. Everyone's out of step with me. Loretta, what do you say to this? The thinnest book ever written.
I just try to think of the dumbest person I know, and I said Mortimer Snerd.
Mortimer Snerd. He wasn't too bright.
I didn't know that.
Okay, Richard?
I didn't say Brett.
You didn't say Brett?
No. I said the lady behind me.
Very good.
Now, Betty, we're looking for...
It could have worked either way. He could have been sitting this way, too, you see. He'd
yeah. Oh, yes. He goes both ways.
Going for Jean?
Now, Miss Betty White is on.
Just because Brett is like
that. Pay attention to Miss Betty White.
I'm going to turn the other cheek. I simply said Brett Summers.
All right. So the score now is 5-3. And we go to round 2. 5-3 in favor of Kay Henry, who now has her choice of A or B.
I'll take A again.
A again. Now, let's see. There's just one person. Who is it?
Laura.
Oh, hello there.
Pressure.
You remember me, don't you?
Yes, the one with the girdle.
Right. Stephanie said, I'm taking classes at Bernie School of Burlesque. It's wonderful. Whenever I do good, Bernie puts a gold star on my blank. Okay. Cut! All right. Okay, you ready? Stephanie said, I'm taking classes at Bernie's School of Burlesque, and it's wonderful. Whenever I do good, Bernie puts a gold star on my blank.
Rear end.
Rear end. All right. I suppose there are two ways to go here, the upper extremity or the lower extremity. Did you choose either or neither?
I said G-string.
G-string. That does not match her answer. She said rear end. So, we've got to stop right here now before we give you your second round question. You've got to... We are ready to carry on here. Now, you know what you have to do, Brian?
Yes, I do.
What?
I've got to match all my people.
Two to tie, three to win. All right, here we go. George and Brett play... And Loretta plays. Fred said, boy, was that airline rotten. At dinner time, the passengers in first class got egg drop soup, while the passengers in coach got blank drop soup. That's a rotten airline. Yes, of course. A rotten airline. At dinner time, the passengers in first class got egg drop soup. The passengers in coach got blank drop soup.
I love that name. Isn't that a wonderful name, Brian?
Brian, yes.
Yeah, it's a lovely name.
It's spelled B-R-I-A-N-N-E. Here you go. Fred said that. A rotten airline. You got it. Okay. Okay, Brian. Was that airline rotten? At dinner time, the passengers in first class got egg drop soup, while the passengers in coach got blank drop soup.
Bird.
Bird drop. Now, you want chicken egg drop or you want some other kind of soup? What do you want? You want one from column A? Oh, bird drop soup. That's very good. That's one for her. Score now 5-4. What do you say?
I say she sings like a bird.
A bird drop soup. We got a tie score now. So you've achieved the tie. You get one more match here with Loretta Swit and you win another game. Show and tell time.
I said bird's nest.
Bird's nest.
No.
Bird's nest?
Yeah!
All right, that wins the game. Come on down. Congratulations. So, you hang around there for a minute in the show while we say goodbye to Kay Henry. We'll be sending you some gifts, Kay Henry, and it was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you. It's a pleasure being here.
Goodbye, Kay Henry.
Bye.
Thank you. Now, Brian, here we go again. There it is. We polled a recent studio audience, remember? We got their best response to this. Blank beaver. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. $250 for the middle one, remember, and $100 for the bottom one. You've been here before. You know how it goes. Choose your celebrities.
Loretta, please.
Eager.
Eager Beaver. There's one.
Richard.
My favorite show, Leave It to Beaver.
Leave It to Beaver. That's good.
And Charles.
I chose Gene Busy as a...
Busy as a Beaver. Eager Beaver and Leave It to Beaver. Those are the three. You want one of those or have you got one of your own?
Leave It to Beaver.
Leave It to Beaver. Okay, it's the one that Richard gave you. We'll find out if it's up there and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom, Brian, and reveal the $100 response. Busy Beaver. Well, we kind of had that from one of the celebrities. Let's see if we get Leave It to Beaver under the $250 number. Eager Beaver. This looks pretty good. I think it's going to be up there. Don't you think it's going to be up there? Yeah. All right, Earl, show and tell. Yes, sirree. Congratulations. Now you're over $4,000. And you're going to play for 10 times the amount or $5,000. But remember what you have to do to get the money. You got to match one celebrity.
Brett, please.
Brett. Brett, you are no longer sick.
Right, I'm a well woman.
You're a well woman. Okay, here we go with Brett for $5,000. All right. Get your ESP going over to Brett now. Blank Park. Blank Park. P-A-R-K.
Where she's from, can I?
No, you can't. Just write an answer. Get your ESP going over to her. She's got it flowing over to you now. Come up with the same answer. Now she's finally finished, Bryn. All right, there it is. Blank Park. What answer do you want to give us you think will match hers and collect the $5,000?
Central.
Central Park. Well, Brian, I agree with you. I ran through every one of them in my mind, and I said, well, that's the most famous park in the world, and if I were playing, I'd write it, and I hope you wrote it so she gets some money.
If I'd only known that she was from the East, I would have said Central Park.
Ah, you said it! $9,050. How about that?
That's pretty darn good.
That's very good. Congratulations to you, Brian. You've really got a lot of loot here now, and you're going to meet another player, so let's welcome Carrie Shore. Hi, Carrie. Who is it stuck, Brian? Carrie, we'll welcome you and ask you to tell us the Carrie Shore story.
Okay, I'm originally from New York, now living in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And I'm married. I have a lovely wife, Kathy. And I play soccer, ski, and play beach volleyball.
Beach volleyball.
Yeah.
Where do you ski mostly?
In California, up north, Mammoth.
I see. Yeah. All right. And would you have said Central Park? Is she were you playing it in your mind back there?
I probably would have.
Central Park,
yeah.
Being from the East, I guess you would. But she's not. Where are you from originally?
Providence, Rhode Island.
Providence, Rhode Island, but not New York City. You did say Central Park. Well, good for you. Now, we found out about Carrie Shore. We can't start the game at this instant. We've got to do something else, and this is it. Well, listen, we've got just about a minute. It's not quite enough time to do a question, so we're going to ask you to hold everything until we get together next time. Look forward to seeing you then, all right?
Okay.
You were dandy.
Yeah.
You've done it again. Don't forget to watch for Loretta Swit on MASH. No, The Blue Knight, yes. Or are you on The Blue Knight? You're on the Mary Tyler Moore show. He's on The Blue Knight. She's on MASH, and they're all wonderful.
And you can buy The Belle of Amherst in recording or in your bookstore.
No kidding.
Yes, it's published.
Hey, that's good news. She did the whole thing?
The whole play.
On two LPs.
With Brooks Atkinson's comments, which are wonderful.
How marvelous.
It is true.
Well, okay. We sell it on Family Feud.
I was going to say, if you bought it, you would save having a Family Feud, is what I was going to say.
Say goodbye, Gracie.
Goodbye, Gracie. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Be ready. Goodbye.